Hello everyone, welcome back to WAYN Games for another tutorial in the dots training series. In the beginning of the series, we discovered the core principles of ECS. Today, we will use all that knowledge to make dozens of entities at runtime using a prefab as template. We will learn about entity command buffers and the importance of system execution order. And since it's Halloween season, as a bonus at the end of the video, we will use a free skeleton from the asset store to replace our cube, and prepare it for animation later in the series. Before we start, quick information. Unity keeps releasing new versions of the packages. This week, we have a new release that patches some bugs. For big projects, you probably want to think before you update the package's version. But for our tutorial series, I will upgrade the Unity and package version every time I get the opportunity. I will add in the description the version I use and tell you at the beginning of the video if those changed. Like today, we will be using the 2022.2.0b13 version of Unity with the 1.0.0 experimental.14 version of the dots packages. With that out of the way, let's make lots of entities. First thing first, we want to make a spawner, and we will need to tell it what to spawn and when to spawn it. So let's make a prefab out of our cube. Create a prefabs folder and drag your cube from the hierarchy to the folder. By doing that, we will lose all the references to our path. To avoid this, we could drag the path waypoints game object under the cube before making it a prefab. But doing so will no longer allow us to set the path in the scene, since it will be part of the prefab. So I prefer to transfer that responsibility to the spawner itself. It will also make it much easier to swap the spawn prefab. I'll make an empty and drag the path under it, and remove the missing game object references from the prefab. Now, let's make the spawner scripts. In the autoring folder, make a new C# script called spawner autoring. Open it and add a game object field for our prefab, another float field for the time between each spawn, and a list of transforms that will be automatically populated by the list of the children's transform. We'll use link to remove the spawner's own position from the list, since the get components in children also return the object itself. Below it, make your baker. We can already add the dynamic buffer of waypoint and set its content. For the rest, we will need to make a new ECS component. I will create it in the current file and move it later. Let's call it spawner data and declare an entity field and a float field. We will also need another float field to keep track of when the next spawn should happen. First one needs to keep its value to reset the timer. Now we can add the data in the baker. To get the prefab as an entity, we can simply use the getEntity method. This method accepts either a game object or a monobehavior component of the game object. I will move the component to its own script and place it under the correct folder. Now, if we go back to Unity and set things up, you will notice that we do have our prefab entity and spawner, but nothing gets spawned. If you follow the series, you should already know that's because we don't have a system for it yet. We'll make one and use entity command buffers to spawn the prefab entities just after a 2-second break. Just the time for you to hit the like button. Thank you! Now, I talked about entity command buffers. But what are they? Entity command buffers are queue of operations to perform on entities. An operation can either be a structural change, create, destroy entity, or add remove components on entities, or just setting the data on a component. The default game loop provides a few systems that execute command buffer at the beginning and end of each major system group. It is important to be aware of their order when you use them and to understand that the queued command will be delayed until that system executes. Let's say we have a system running in the initialization group. They enqueue a destroy entity command in the begin simulation system and a set data command in the end simulation system. By the time the set data command will be executed, the entity will no longer exist, as it was removed by the destroy command. So you will get an exception. Let's make the system to see how it's implemented. In the systems folder, make a new script called spawner system. Open it, replace the content with an iSystem. First, we need to create the entity command buffer of our choice using the following code. Then, in the for each, we need the spawner data and the dynamic buffer of waypoints. We can use the command buffer to spawn the entity, and then copy the path from the spawner to the newly created entity. We also need to add the next path index on the entity. The prefab baker will not have done it since the prefab does not have any waypoints initially defined. Now, if we go back to Unity and enter play mode, this time we should see new cube appear every second. Great, it works. We can even speed things up by reducing the spawn time. Before the Halloween bonus, I would like to explain why I picked that buffer. If you look at the systems window, you will see that our system is executed in the simulation group. That group also contains the transform systems. If I had used the end simulation buffer, the entity would be created just before the presentation system group. But the transform system would not have run on it yet. This can create a visual artifact where the entity is shown at 000 for one frame before teleporting to its position. That's why I prefer to delay the creation of the entity to the next frame using the begin simulation command buffer. Now, don't skip the Halloween bonus since it will set us up for the next video. I'm going to use this free skeleton from the asset store. I'm not allowed to distribute it even if it's free, so I will add it to a third-party folder that I've excluded from the Git commit. If the material is pink in your project, don't worry. We just need to convert the material to be compatible with the universal render pipeline using this menu. We also need to remove the render bound filter on the move system. Set the scale to 0.1. We can then replace the cube with the working version of the skeleton prefab. Enter play mode to see your army of skeletons that for now just slide and are not animated. We will see how to animate them using the hybrid approach in the next video. Thank you for watching, like and share. If you have any feedback or questions, leave them in the comment section or join us on Discord. See you in the next video.